How's it going, everybody? Welcome back and to a new exciting project we're doing today. Today, we're going to be working on this German-style helmet, motorcycle helmet. I've gone ahead already and primed it and taped it up and all that good stuff. I'm going to be shooting some silver, some candy, and some flake on it. It's going to be real nice. Let's get started with some silver. Okay, guys, let's get started. So what we got here, we got our mixing cup. And what today for our silver, we're going to be using Martin Senior's Argento Metallic Silver. We'll be using this, and we also have our Martin Senior Reducer. So this is going to be mixed at a 1-to-1 ratio. We won't need too much of this. I'll be shooting this through my minigun, which has really, really good atomization, so I'll be sticking with that. So we got our 1-to-1 measuring side right there. So we're gonna go, that's not the 1-to-1. Okay, yeah, I got it now. 1-to-1, so we're gonna go 1-to-1. There. That usually happens. Yeah, it was me. So a good thing to do. Put yourself a nice little drainage on the lip of your can in between this gap here, and it lets the paint drain right back into your cup. Oh, this is a nice silver too. Alrighty, so we have our silver. Now, reducer. Now, mixing stick. We want to mix this real good. Great coverage of that. It's going to be a great metallic. Okay, guys, we got a bright sunny day. We got the minigun set up with the silver in it already. Let's get to spraying on this thing. Okay, guys, we're gonna do the second coat now. I noticed I didn't have my respirator last coat, so I'm putting it on this one. I'm also gonna tack wrap the project to get rid of any excess dust or anything, any particles left on it. And I think we'll just do two coats on this. Let's get to spraying. Alrighty, guys, so what we're gonna do now is now that the silver's drying on the helmet, we're gonna start on our getting prepared for our flake. Today we're gonna be using also again Martin Senior binder, basically. Roth Machine Gun Gray Metal Flake. It's actually really, really nice flake. Look at that. Oh, buddy. Yeah. And we'll also be using our Martin Senior reducer. Let's get this mixed up. And this is also a one-to-one mixture. Give this a little shake. Good coverage. I noticed, and I'm sure you all noticed too, that there was a pink hue to the binder, but that pink hue's gone now. Let's keep this agitated. Let's get to shooting this. We also will be using the Roth loose cannon spray gun, flake gun. I'll be using this to shoot my flake. So let's get started. I already gave the helmet a quick little dusting just to see how the flake gun is working out, but I'm gonna go ahead and flake it up right now and let's get it all done. Let's get started. Okay guys, welcome back. We're gonna be doing this part now. I already sanded this all down. It's all smooth. We're gonna be doing our taping patterns now, and then we'll be going over with the candy and maybe some airbrushing and pinstriping on it. We're gonna, I'll see you then. But for now, we're gonna do the taping patterns around here, and I'll show you that once it's completed. Okay guys, we got all the custom graphics and the tapes all taped up here, the patterns and stuff we're going to be doing. We'll be throwing some airbrushing on this to give it some highlight so that when I candy over it, these will pop out a little bit more, have more defined edges. I'll be doing it with a black, which will give it a little bit more depth and stuff in it. So, but there's our custom graphics on this helmet. Tapes up, looking sharp. I think we got a winner here, guys. Okay guys, so what we're gonna start now is we're gonna start with the black on this, with the candy black. We're gonna be using the candy black by Inspire Paints, bought at Custom Shop, custom paints. It's great enamel urethane airbrush paint. Good stuff. And the airbrush I'll be using today is the Neo for Iwata, Great all-around little brush. I love it. Works really well. And I'll be running this at about, I'd say about 20 PSI. Really light. I just want very minimal coverage on this. I'm going to be building it. I'll be building up the coverage on this to suit my needs. Now that all the black is done, all over the helmet, now I'm gonna go ahead and retape all the edges, and then we're gonna shoot some candy over it. I think we'll go candy red on this one. Okay guys, we're back. Now we're gonna be doing the candy. I did go with a candy concentrate wine fire by Sem. Really good looking color. Here it is, a little bit in a bottle, so you can kind of see what it looks like. Very nice. We'll be using it also with my binder here. It's a Martin Senior binder, but it did get that pink hue to it that you might remember seeing earlier when I did the flake, and it did bring out a red hue in the helmet. So I'm gonna go ahead and work with that, and I'm gonna do it red with my candy red concentrate, so we don't have any issues with that color. And I'll be using this Refinisher Solutions RSC 220 clear coat. It works really well. And I'll also be using my Martin Senior reducer here. So let's get mixing this up. Personally, I like to mix my reducer in there before I add my candy concentrate. Sometimes we have an issue with flattening out the color or doing something like that. So I like to do my reduction before that, which is at a 1:1. There. Get our mixing stick. That all mixed up in there. Okay, now we're gonna add in, I already have a candy concentrate here that I was already ready to go. I'm gonna go ahead and use it. You can see it's a really nice red. Really, really nice red. I like this one. Looking forward to seeing how this helmet comes out. Oh yeah. Might even add a little bit more in that. We want to get a little darker. I'd like my candy to be a little darker than that. So we're gonna go ahead and add a little bit more concentrate. Right there. Sometimes I do go by the ratio sometimes, but a lot of the times I have to toy with it myself. Oh, there we go. To toy with it a little bit just so I can bring out the real beautiful red in it like that. That's what we're looking for right there. Right there. That's what we're looking for. Gonna need a bit more reduction. Like I said, I don't like to add the reducer too much afterwards, but this is gonna need it. But it's gonna leave a beautiful red. Okay guys, we got our red candy loaded up, helmet ready, prepped up. Let's start shooting this. All right, fellas, we got the candy all shot down. Came out gorgeous. It's like I knew it would. That wine fire is really pretty color. So now we're gonna go in there. We're gonna peel this tape, put up some shading, some more airbrushing, and then we're gonna hit it with some clear. Okay, the tape's all off. Graphics are there. Came out pretty nice, if I do say so myself. Now, we're gonna put us in some more shading with the black, just to define some lines and some separations, and I think we're gonna be in business. Okay guys, we got it all set up. Let's hit it with some clear. Here it is, guys. Clear on it. Now we just gotta wait for it to dry. All right guys, here's the finished product. Looking sharp. Please like and subscribe if you like this video and like to see more content like this. I'll be doing other projects also. This is absolutely a fun project to do. And I'm looking forward to the next one. Take it easy, guys.